Now, Sadiq Abdul Haq and Shahid Abdul Haq, wanted by the Criminal Investigations Department in connection with the Easter Sunday terror attacks which struck the country, was arrested in Nawalapitiya. The shoe shop in Gampola, owned by their uncle, which was used as their hideout, was searched by security forces once again this morning. Now, police also discovered a video containing statements made by Mohammed Zahran, the mastermind of the attacks, documents belonging to his organization, as well as videos of a suicide bomb attack training conducted in Syria. Police said that the hard disk containing the footage was wrapped in cloth hidden inside a machine used to sew shoes. Meanwhile, police also discovered several burnt hard disks during their search operations today. Well, now the two suspects arrested in Nawalapitiya are brothers of the same family. It has now been revealed that the group that aided and abetted the terrorists were members of a number of families. Charlene Benedict is ready to give us a comprehensive report on this. Just a note, we have compiled this report with the verified and published information we have received from the investigations carried out by the relevant security forces.
Thank you very much, Joel. Now, coming to you from the News First studios here with a special report regarding the attackers who carried out the attack on Easter Sunday, the string of bombings. Now, there are a number of families, as you can see here, involved in this attack. Let's take a look at family number one involved in the attack. The father, Mohammed Yusuf Ibrahim. He's a well-known businessman in Sri Lanka, residing in Dematagoda. He is currently in police custody. Now, this noted individual has 9 children, 6 sons and 3 daughters. Now, within his family, 2 of his sons, Ibrahim Mohammed Ilham and Ibrahim Inshaf Ahmed, were the 2 terror suspects who carried out the attack at the Cinnamon Grand Hotel and Shangri-La Hotel. Now, also, one fact that should be noted is the fact that Ibrahim Inshaf is suspected to have manufactured the bombs at a copper factory owned by him. Father Mohammed Ibrahim Yusuf and his 2 sons who were involved in this attack, all 3 are currently in the custody of police. Also, Ibrahim Mohammed Irfan, the eldest son out of the 2 brothers who carried out the attack, was arrested only yesterday. Now, it was Ibrahim Inshaf Ahmed's pregnant wife who detonated the explosives at his house in Dematagoda, which also unfortunately claimed the lives of 3 security personnel. Also, one thing that should be noted is the fact that her children were present with her at the time she exploded the suicide vest, and of course all of them are deceased currently. Moving on with the rest of the families that were involved in this, family tree number 2. Taking a look at this, the mastermind behind the attacks is obviously known as Mohammed Zahran. Now, this has been confirmed by security forces, and we have continued to report on this during the past few days as well. The suspect he's suspected to have died in the Shangri-La attack. He is the terror suspect who carried out the Shangri-La attacks. He's 33 years old. He has 2 brothers and 2 sisters. Moving on with more information, the brother of Mohammed Zahran, Mohammed Rilwan, and father died at the blast that occurred at the house in Saidamandu, Samanture. Now, this was the blast where 15 individuals were killed in Samanture. His brother and father were among them. His wife and 4-year-old daughter were among the survivors in that blast. Now, it must be noted the fact that the child that you saw in video footage that was released during the past few days, the child that the armed forces were carrying and taking very good care of, the child injured in the Samanture blast was none other than the mastermind's child. Moving on, there is no information available about the remaining 2 brothers and 2 sisters of the mastermind of this terror attack. Moving on to family number 3 involved in this terror attack. The Abdul Haq family, Sahid Abdul Haq and Sadiq Abdul Haq. Both of these brothers were arrested by police forces. Also, one thing that should be noted is the fact that the photographs of these 2 suspects were released to the media, and the police sought public assistance to arrest these suspects, and these suspects are currently in remand custody at the moment. Now, it should be noted that Sadiq Abdul Haq has traveled to Syria twice and received training in Syria before he had returned to the island. He is once again currently in police custody. These are the images released by security forces of the two brothers, Sahid Abdul Haq and Sadiq Abdul Haq, in the custody of the Nawalapitiya police. Now, Fatima Latifa, the second wife of Sadiq Abdul Haq, and she too is in the custody of the Mavanalla police. Now, it must be noted that a photograph of Fatima Latifa was also released by the police, and they sought public assistance to identify these suspects. Now, it is clear that all these suspects involved in this terror attack belong to just three families. Of course, this net could be wider. Only information revealed by the police forces and security forces will tell us how wide this net goes and how low, as in how great this threat is to Sri Lanka. Of course, we here at News First will continue to report on credible information to the general public. For now, the details revealed by the police forces is that three of these families were involved in this terror attack, and they are all either they died in suicide attacks or they are in police custody.